To order the Seeing and Doing teacher's notes for the autumn term, price £1.10, pupils' language book, price 95 pence, pupils' writing book, price 95 pence, anthologies 1 and 2, price £3.95 each, and the Shape Up software, price £17.75, please contact your local ITV company. Alternatively, send a cheque or postal order to Schools Publications Office, Thames Television, 149 Tottenham Court Road, London, W1P 9LL.
Scotland, I expect.
Yeah, probably was.
Finding out about your family history will give you many clues to the past.
Rosemary was on the Queen Mary.
We've been trying to find out things about our families, and you've all taken home questionnaires, and you've all come back with lots of things for us to look at. Can you tell us some of the things that you've found? Laura?
I've got lots of loads of birth certificates.
Could we have a look at them?
First, let's see what can be discovered from birth certificates.
Do you know whose it is, Laura?
I think it's my granddad's.
What's his name?
John Robert.
John Robert. And can you show us where you can find out what year he was born in?
1931.
Right. What other things can we find out from his birth certificate?
His father was James Murray.
Right. Now, who would James Murray be in your family then? If that's your grandfather, who would that be?
My great-grandfather.
That's right, good girl, that's your great-grandfather. Has it got any other information on there that we can find out?
His mother, Elsie Laura Murray.
Elsie Laura Murray. Oh, she's got the same name as you then, in the middle. Are there any other Laura Murrays in the family that you know of?
No.
Can we have a look at what you've got in your bag, Amanda?
Yes. First of all, I got my mummy's christening hat.
Right, that's lovely. So this is what your mum wore when she was christened. Little satin bonnet, little fur trim on there. That's lovely. What else?
Old photographs also provide useful talking points.
My dad's dad.
Your dad's dad.
Yeah.
Can you show the others? That's Amanda's...
Perhaps we could look on our family
tree. Right, we could perhaps find his name on your family tree. Fred.
Oh, love Fred.
Right, so we need to find a Fred on your family tree, don't we?
I've got some papers from when I was born. In one of the papers, I've got a picture of my mum and dad when they got married.
Yes, can you read us the date of this one?
Tuesday, October 24th, 1972.
Let's find the page with your picture of your mum and dad on.
Somewhere around there. Picture of my mum and dad.
Oh, right. Can you read just what it says at the top there?
Farabee Jones.
Right, so...
Brian A. Carpenter and Joyner met Jane, a secretary, at St George's Hospital Medical School when they both worked.
Right, so that actually describes what their jobs were. Right, Scott, can you tell us what you found out about your family?
That's me and my brother when we just moved here and I was seven.
And who's this?
My mum and dad's wedding day.
That's right. You can tell it's their wedding day because of the clothes they're wearing.
And that's my mum's mum and dad.
On their wedding day too. Right, that's lovely. So that's your grandparents. I think you've probably got enough information there now to start on your family tree. So... this is what we're going to fill in with your information. Where are you going to start?
There, because I have to put the information about me in the bottom and work my way up to the top.
Put your name in first, then. And what else are you going to put with it?
My date of birth.
Good, well done.
Scott has traced his family history back to his great-grandmother, who's still alive. they're able to visit her and ask some questions about the family.
How many brothers and sisters did you have, Granny?
9 sisters and 2 brothers.
Goodness.
9, 10, 11, that's right, isn't
it? You show Amy this picture, you can show
Old people can tell us a lot of interesting things about the past.
I think I was about 12.
That's Granny there. So, there's a picture, and that's a little boy. And yet, it's dressed like a little girl.
There's my uncle. That's my brother Jim. Mm. That's the way they were dressed in those days. Unless, of course, Mother had so many girls, she wanted to still dress the boy as a girl. I don't know which.
What we had, what was left of the girls.
It's rather nice, though, isn't it?
Yeah. Who are the oldest ones in your family?
Well, my sister Elsie, she was out in America, but of course she's dead now. There's only my sister. You know Auntie Lil, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, there's only Auntie Lil and I left out of the old family. We're the only two that's alive.
What jobs did your brothers do when they left
school?
My
brother was on the railway. Mm-hmm. He was an engine driver.
Mm-hmm.
But I think the girls, you know, were in service.
Yes, that's what most of the girls seemed to do.
That was the thing, I think, in those days.
Yes.
And, of course, Mother had such a large family.
They learned that her life as a child was quite different from their lives today.
Right, this afternoon we're going to try and find out some information about Claire's family. Claire has a great-grandma who's still alive at the moment. What sort of things could we use as clues to Claire's family?
Birth certificates.
Yes, that's right, that's a good one.
Photos.
Already the children have ideas for finding out.
Parish registers. Right. Does anybody know what a parish register is?
No, I do. It's where, like, if someone's born, they write it down, or if someone's getting married, they write it down.
That's right. Right, Claire, I don't know if you can give us any clues about your great-grandma, perhaps her name and the year she was born. Do you know those?
No, not very well, but I know her surname.
And what was her surname?
Hugh.
Now, what we're going to do is have a look at these copies from the parish register. I'm going to ask you to look out for the family name of Q somewhere on here.
As Claire's great-grandmother's family used to live nearby, there are several places to explore and questions to ask about the Q family.
Yes, have you all found the Q? Right. Lucy, perhaps you could tell us what the name of the child was.
Muriel Eileen.
So we've got Muriel Eileen Q. Gemma, what have you got?
I've got Sarah Jane.
Right. Mira? No.
I've got Alice Q.
Alice Q.
I've got Ernest Harold.
William Charles.
Edith Daisy.
Edith Daisy, right. Now then, I wonder if there's any way we can find out which one was Claire's great-grandma. Do you happen to know your great-grandma's Christian name?
Edith Daisy.
Edith Daisy, that's right. So who had Edith Daisy on their parish register? Scott. Right. Can you tell us, by looking at your parish register, the year that Edith Daisy was christened in?
1898.
Now, by looking across the line where Edith Daisy's written down, can you tell us what her parents' names were?
William,
that's right.
And Eliza.
William and Eliza. Good. Can you all have a look and see what parents' names you've got on your copies?
William and Eliza.
So, if all the parents' names were the same, what does it tell us about the children on these parish registers?
They're all brothers and sisters.
They're all brothers and sisters, that's right. Good. So they were all your great-grandma's brothers and sisters. Well, Claire and I actually went to see Claire's great-grandma, and Claire's dad took a video of us asking her some questions to try and find out about what life was like when she was a child. Did Claire tell you we've been looking at some of the parish registers? We've actually found your name entered on the Register of Baptisms.
Well, my old dad must have been born up there at Ellisfield somewhere, you see.
Yeah.
If you want
wanted to get something from the shop, how long would it take you to get there?
Well, we had no shops near us. We had to go right from here right down to Clydeston. We'd have to go, well, I suppose about a mile and a half or 2 miles. Mm. Yeah, but that old cottage where I was born is still there. Mm. Have you seen it?
No, I haven't. I must go and have a look, though.
Oh, I guess somebody's bought it now and just sort of modernised it. But it's stuck right there in the middle of nowhere. You're on your own.
And this is the cottage where Edith Daisy Kew was born. It's having a new thatched roof, and the old cottage has been made quite modern now. Just think what a long walk Edith, Daisy and her brothers and sisters had to take across these fields to go to school. Today, Claire and her friends visit the old school to see what they can find out about Edith Daisy's school days.
Hello.
Hello.
What a nice sunny day with you. How are you getting on with your research into the Kew family?
All right.
You wanted to have a look at the admission register, I believe. Is that right?
Yes.
Well, here it is. It's very old. It's falling to pieces. But if I put it down there, we'll open it at the K page. And there are all the Kew children down there. See them? Can you read the names?
We never knew Angus, Edward, Elsie, Daisy, Alice, William.
Have you seen Daisy?
Who's that?
Which one did you want, are you interested in particularly?
Daisy.
Daisy. Right, we'll find admission number 112 then.
At first, the old writing is difficult to read.
Q Daisy.
And there's their father's name, look.
William, and their mother's and that's her name date is Eliza.
Oh, it? Was it? Well, that doesn't show on here. And there's her birthday, look. 6th of August.
Oh, that's my that's the same as mine. Mine's 6th of August.
Is it? But no, you weren't born in 1899, were you?
But my birthday's the 6th of August.
There you are. You can work out how old she is now.
91.
Here's the churchyard.
The churchyard is another place to look for clues of family history. Here, other members of the Kew family may have been buried. The children examine the writing on the gravestones carefully.
Died 5th of January, 1898.
That's when Stacey was born.
Yes.
That's strange.
One person dies and one person's born.
Mm. Right, so we're going to have a look at that one over there, huh?
Yeah.
Some are so old and worn that the names cannot be read anymore. They'll continue their search in other churchyards. Finding out about the past isn't always easy. It takes a lot of time and patience.
Right, Claire, you've worked very hard on your family tree here, and you started to put the information onto your timeline. And you've colour-coded all the levels on your family tree. And you've got a pencil line here, which matches this pencil line here. And who have you written in at this
That's
level?
That's my name.
And when were you born?
1981.
If we go a little bit further back, we've got a red line here, which matches this red line at this level. And who have you got at that level?
Mum and Dad.
Right, and when were they born?
1957.
Good. And this is your great-grandparents that you've coloured in green here. And this is Edith Daisy, your great-grandmother, who's still alive now. And when was she born?
1898.
Right, so could you put in Edith Daisy's name?
And so Claire finishes off her timeline, covering 100 years of her family. Tracing your family tree is a way of finding out about history.
notebook.
Yeah, it looks old. You can see where
this must be cleaned.
A baby. Yeah. What's it got in its hand?
Spade, I think.
It's a big one, though. Mm. And a bucket. Strange table. Just come home for work.